In this video, we're gonna cover how to link to data that's located on a different Excel file. And we're gonna talk about how to do it in a way that even when you make changes and mess around with that file, your link still works. And I'm gonna do this both with local files and files saved in SharePoint or OneDrive. So it doesn't matter, it's gonna work for both, and I'm gonna show you what the differences are. So first of all, let's take this first file and I'm gonna add a few numbers on this file. So I'll just go to this C column. I'll just enter a few different numbers here so we have something to work with. So these are the numbers I'm trying to point to. So let's try to now link to these numbers from a different Excel file. So first of all, I'm just gonna save this file. Before I save it though, let me rename the sheet. So instead of sheet one, let's just double click on this and call this main data, or really anything you want to call this. And I'm gonna go control S to save this. I'm gonna save this on OneDrive. You can do it in SharePoint. I'm also gonna save that same file locally in a minute so you can see what the differences are. So I'm just gonna call this my file on OneDrive. So that's gonna be the name of this file. So I'm also very quickly gonna save this file locally. So here we are, I have my local file here that's called my local file, and I have the other one I just saved on OneDrive, which is really just the same file, just another copy over here. So now I'm gonna just start a whole new Excel file. So that's Control N for new. And here's our whole new workbook. This is where I'm actually gonna do the formula. And I'm just gonna keep it simple. I'm just gonna do a sum of these numbers. So to do that, I'm just gonna push this on the side here, this other spreadsheet. And I'm simply just gonna go equal sum, open parentheses. And then once I open parentheses, I'm just gonna click on this other file, select this list of numbers. And then on top here, I'm just gonna close parentheses in a formula bar and hit enter, and that gives me the total. So this was from the local file, so I'll just call this local. And this one, I'm gonna call it cloud. And for this one, I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna use the data that's on this file, which is the OneDrive file or cloud file. So once again, I'll just do the same thing. I'll open my first file. While I have the other one open, I'll go here equal sum, open parentheses. And after I open parentheses, I'm just gonna go here, select this list, close parentheses right here in the formula bar, hit enter, and I get the same total, not surprisingly, because, well, it's the same data. So now at this point, what I'm gonna do for a minute, I'm just gonna close the other two files so you can see what's actually happening here. So once the other two files are closed now, let's look at these formulas to see what they look like. So if I look at this formula, the first one, so if you look at this formula, there's this part after exclamation sign, which is the range C2 through C5. Then we have this part before exclamation sign in single quotes, which is the source. And the source consists of three parts. We have this part right after the square brackets, which is the name of the sheet, which is called main data. So if you remember when I was saving the file, I called the worksheet in the bottom there main data. And then before that in square brackets, we have the name of the file, which is called my local file. .xlsx is the extension. And then before that, before the square brackets, we have the path to where the file is located. Now, this would be that example of a local file. So it's telling me it's on my C drive in this folder, this folder, this folder. So that's what this looks like for a local link. Now, if we look at this cloud option, it's gonna be very similar. Now here again, it's just very long. For that reason, it just goes over multiple lines, as you can see. But once again, if we look at this exclamation sign over here, what follows that exclamation sign is this range, which is the same range. And then before that exclamation in single quotes, we have again the source. And once again, the source consists of three parts. We have the name of the sheet, main data, and then in square brackets, the name of the file, which I named my file on OneDrive.xlsx. So far, exactly the same. And before that, now we have this, which is the path to where the file is located. And because it's not a local file, it's on SharePoint, it's gonna be the SharePoint link, the SharePoint location over here. So the rest is the same. It's still the formula pointing to the other file. So all of this is fine, and it seems like it's working no problem until we start messing with our source files. So first of all, let me just save this summary file. I'm just gonna go Control S and call this summary. And now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna close this one and open the other two files. So here we go, the other file is closed. We're now looking at this other two Excel files. This is one of them. So let's say now you go in this file and you start adding some new columns, or maybe you start adding some rows or this type of thing. I'm just gonna add a column. So now as I add a column, this range moved to D column. I'm gonna save this, and I'm gonna repeat the same thing on the other file that is local file. I'm just gonna close this after I make this change. And the same thing here, we're gonna add a new column in this local file, we're gonna save it, Control S. And at this point, I'm just gonna close this file and open our summary file. So as I open this, because I'm opening it locally, it's asking me to enable content to update the links. And the moment I do that, this is what's gonna happen. So I'm gonna trust this document. You can see that both of these no longer work. So first of all, like this one, it's not gonna work because see, it's sourcing the data from C column, but because we ended up adding another column, it's no longer there. It's now in D column. Now it's summing the numbers from C column. There are no numbers, so we get a zero. And then the same exact problem we're gonna have here. So again, C column, it's no longer in C column. And now we got a broken system. So what are we gonna do to avoid this? We're gonna use a named range instead of using this. Now I've done a video about this on Google Sheets. It's very similar in logic of what I'm doing here. It's just implementation is a little different. So I'm gonna go ahead and open those two other files. So here's the one that's local. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna start by creating a named range. So I'm gonna select this data over here. And then I'm gonna select this box in a corner. And that's what we call a name box in Excel. And I'm just gonna name this range. I'm gonna call this sales amounts. You can call it anything you want, but no spaces or no special characters. I'm calling it sales amounts, uppercase S, uppercase A, hit enter. And that's the named range. Now all these named ranges, I'm gonna show you how to update them and stuff in just a second if you have to. But right now I'll just do this and I'm gonna save this file. And then I'm gonna do the same for that cloud file. So I'll select that same list, call it sales amount or sales amounts, hit enter. And that's the name of this range now. And once again, I'm gonna save this. And now we have a named range in both files. So now I'll go back to our summary file. So of course our summary file still doesn't work. So if I go and open this, it's still trying to source it from this C column. So if you remember, we have this name of the sheet followed by this named range. So I'm gonna just go here and select all of this right after exclamation sign and just call it sales amount. By the way, it was sales amounts, not sales amount. So I wanna make sure I match it. And right now, if I hit enter, see, that works now. It will get me 140. So then I'll do the same exact thing with this cloud version. So I'm gonna open this one. And once again, instead of this, I'm gonna change it to sales amounts. I got a name error, so I'm going to assume I didn't give it the right name when I was naming this sales amounts. Let's go and double check and make sure I have the right name. So here's our cloud file. I'm gonna go back to formulas, and then I'm gonna go to name manager to check my names. Click edit. I cannot see the problem, but I'm just gonna just update the sales amounts again, hit okay, to make sure we got that right. And then once I save it, apparently I had some sort of mistype. So as you can see now, it works for both of them, no problem. We got our totals. But because now I'm using a named range, now I don't have to worry when people add or remove columns from our previous spreadsheet. So now I should be able to go back and reopen the other files and close this one. So I'm gonna close again this one, and I'm gonna reopen the other two files. So here's the local file. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just delete some columns. So what should happen now, this entire thing has moved to column A, but the thing is we're not linking to column A, we're linking to that named range. And our named range, if I open here and click on sales amounts, you can see it updates automatically to this. So I'm gonna save this. Maybe we should also just change one of these numbers so we can see the update. So I'll change this to 999, this first number, save this one. And then I'll also do the same thing on the second file. So here's the cloud version. I'm gonna delete these columns. Once again, this is that sales amounts, named range, and I'll just change this to a new number, save this. And now I'm just gonna close this and reopen our summary file so we can see what happened. So here we go, now that I've opened that file that has links to other files, it's gonna ask me if I wanna update this. I'm gonna say yes. And you can see very seamlessly, we got both of these totals to update to a new total with that new number. And there is really nothing to fix in the formula because it's pointing to that same range called sales amounts. And you can see it works with both, with the cloud version and with local version, the same exact way. By the way, in Excel, if you want to be able to see what other files you're pointing to from this file, there is a nice way to do this, and you can do that by going to this data section. And under this data section, there's this thing called workbook links. Now in older versions, this used to be called edit links. Now it's renamed to workbook links. The same thing. So if I open this, see, it's going to show me what other files I'm linking to from this file. One of them is linking to this file, the other one is this file. So this is super useful when you have large spreadsheets with a lot going on and you want to see what other source files you're using in this file. You can simply just go here and see all of this. And this is our cloud file and this is our local file. And if you wanted to, you also have the ability to click on these and update the file to a different file if you want to, or open the file to see the file. So there are options here. And there you go. Hopefully this makes sense. And this is how you can create solid links to other Excel spreadsheets without worrying what would happen if somebody adds or deletes a column or adds a row or something like that. So just use a named range. And the final thing I should go over, which I kind of ended up doing because I had one of the names apparently incorrectly when I was doing this, is how to update those named ranges. So I'm just gonna open one of the files. It's really the same for local or cloud file. So an example of that could be maybe you have more data here, you want to include it, or maybe you want to change it to the whole column A, so as you get more data in this column, it's automatically included in that total. And for that, you're gonna have to go to formulas and click name manager. And this is where you're gonna find the name range you just did, sales amounts. You can click edit and you can modify this. So you can see currently this is what it is. Now, if I need to change that to a different list, I can delete this and maybe select this whole column A to link to the entire column A instead. hit OK, close this, and there we go. That's how you update your named ranges. And one last thing I want to talk about is that, remember how I went to that formula in my summary and I had to manually update that name of the range? And then if I make a mistake, I had a problem. Now, you could have avoided all of that by starting with this file and naming the range first. So for example, right now I already have this whole column A named sales amounts. And with that now, if I go now to that summary sheet, and I'm just going to delete both of these formulas from here and start over. So if you're just starting fresh and you have to build a new formula, I'm gonna just push this to the side a little bit so we can see both files. I could just go here and do equal sum, open parentheses. Once I open parentheses, I'm gonna go to this other file and click on this whole column A. And I'm gonna go to this formula bar on top here, close parentheses, and hit enter. And if I do this now, once again, I'm gonna close that other file, the source file, and let's look at our formula. And if you look at this formula, you'll see it's using that name. So if you already have it named first, you don't really have to go change it. It will pick up on that name as you create the formula and you should be good. So if you just go with that order, let's name the range first and then let's make the formula, you wouldn't have to go back and update anything. And that's all you need to know how to create solid links to other Excel files. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.